In the last episode, Carol kissed the Blarney Stone.
I thought you were going to break your back.
It was scary.
Yeah.
Welcome back to the channel. We are Carol and Ken, and we like touring in our little red camper.
Morning, we heard what we thought was somebody tampering with the rear of the van doors. And when we opened the curtains to have a look, it was a magpie.
Welcome back to the channel. It's the 6th of September now, and we're on our way to Cobh.
Is this Cobh or
Cobh? I think.
Cobh?
Yeah, as in C-O-V-E.
Alright. Someone will let us know, how do we pronounce this place, please? Is that the free car park?
Steep, isn't it?
This is a really steep hill. Only first gear in here. It's a challenge, isn't it?
Wow, look at these houses.
I can't remember. Did Danny and Maz come through this? I seem to remember they may have come through this archway and it was very tight for them. There's the White Star Line office.
Yeah.
Finding a place to park proved much harder than I thought it would, and I think we got the last space going here. These are the offices of the White Star Line, and on the 11th of April 1912, 123 passengers boarded the Titanic from here, and only 44 of them survived the sinking.
Did you get it?
Oh, nice light on it now, look.
Yeah, beautiful, isn't it?
This is Cobh Cathedral. Building started in September 1868, but it wasn't completed until 1919. All these people are queuing to go to Spike Island, which is an island in Cork Harbour with a large fort on it, Fort Mitchell. Spike Island tours are sold out today. This statue is in memory of Sonia O'Sullivan, an Irish former track and field athlete. She won a gold medal in the 5,000 metres at the 1995 World Championships. Whoever has to repaint this bollard have got their work cut out.
Can you have a look in there? Yeah.
Annie Moore was only 15 years old when she became the first immigrant to be processed at Ellis Island. Cobh was one of the major transatlantic Irish ports, and the town was the departure point for 2.5 million of the 6 million Irish people who emigrated to North America between 1848 and 1950. A first class ticket on the Titanic was £77, while third class was over £7. Another ship to be associated with the town was the Cunard passenger liner RMS Lusitania, which was sunk by a German U-boat on the 7th of May 1915. Whoever captured that expression is an absolute genius. Nestling under the trees here is a memorial to the Cobh volunteers who took part in the 1916 Easter Rising. We're always on the hunt for some boiled sweets, so we took the opportunity to stock up here.
I always think a memorial so much better when you've got the racket from a burger van.
The weather's great and it's time to move on and take advantage of it. We really enjoyed our visit to Cobh and we would recommend it to anybody. We're at Lidl now and it was here that we saw this fantastic old camper van. I managed to speak with the owner when he came back and he told me that they'd only just bought it. He was surprised that I liked it so much, but I think the styling is absolutely fantastic. I'm on the hunt for my favourite cakes, which are pastel de nata, a Portuguese egg custard tart.
Yeah, why not? Right, how are we doing? Episode 14 is nearly uploaded. Been very handy, this Lidl. Not only have we been able to stock up with supplies, but we've had our lunch and we've got a good 4G signal here to upload a movie.
We noticed a few of these sort of scarecrow figures around the town, so it must be a local tradition here. Things are a lot busier now. We're queuing at the bridge just by Belvelli Castle. We're on our way to a place called Youghal now, which is a seaside resort town in County Cork. Right, here we are. Youghal is among a small number of towns designated as Irish heritage ports by the Irish Tourist Board. The Vikings used to use this town as their base for raids on monastic sites along the southern coast of Ireland.
Sussing out where we are because I'd had a planned route. Now we're a bit off the route.
This impressive structure is the Clock Gate Tower, and it was built on the site of Trinity Castle. It was used as a prison during the rebellion of 1798, and the military hanged suspects from a pole lashed from the lower windows. There are lots of little tiny side streets here, and in this one we can see a little bit of the old town wall. We We're walking northeast along Main Street here. On the right hand side we have Tyne's Castle. This is a late 15th century urban tower house. This is an example of Dutch architecture known as the Red House, built around 1710. We're now looking at the 17th century almshouses which were constructed by Richard Boyle, the first Earl of Cork in 1602, for widows. Each tenant received 2 shillings a week, which was enough to sustain her. Yep, certainly did.
Very historic town, very interesting.
Yeah, lots to see. I needed to stretch my legs as well, they were going numb. And we're back.
No matter how small the parking space, we can get into it.
Yeah, now it's our turn to drive down it.
I bet you're thinking of those swinging bodies.
What are you off to now then, Shrimpy?
Stop in Ardmore to look at the Round Tower. It's one of the best preserved ones in the whole of Ireland.
This is St. Declan's Round Tower, an oratory with Ardmore in the background. The tower was built in the 12th century and it stands 30 metres tall. If all was lost, people would retreat to this tower and pull up the ladder and hope that the stout door would save them.
There's the doorway, high off the ground for refuge.
This little church dates from the 12th century and is the reputed final resting place of St. Declan.
Where's your park up?
I will know when I see it on the map, but I can't remember the name of the place. Is this it? Yeah, here. No, Bun Mahon.
Mm-hmm.
Bun Mahon.
Give him a thumbs up. Yeah, we got one back.
That's a view down there, isn't it?
Yep. Made it with only 4.4 metres of length.
God, it's narrow down here, isn't it?
So far, we've only ever not been able to get under one height barrier, but this point here was so tight, there was a point where we thought we might even have to reverse back.
You need the mirror anymore.
All was good, and we got through.
Total gridlock here.
I am joking when I say that. It's very rare to be held up very much when you're travelling around Ireland.
All of the restaurants are absolutely heaving at the moment. We spoke to a guy in Cobh when we went to Lidl, and he was saying that he had some friends come down last night and they couldn't get a restaurant anywhere.
Puedes decir sí, ¿quién puede decidir? Sin rodeos dices simplemente soy así. Si no nos lo notificas, el silencio sigue ahí. No simules ser sincero, reconoce solo, di que sí. No puedes decir sí, siquiera di que no. Si nos dices no cono, seremos que es que no.
So tonight we're making meatballs and spaghetti with a few mushrooms and some onions and mixed veg. Ooh, making that pan too hot. Let that cool down a bit. And it's going to be in with the meatballs. So I've got meatballs in here now, some frozen veg, mushrooms and onions. And in a minute I'm going to add the sauce and then the spaghetti and cook it all in one pan, see how that turns out. Never tried cooking spaghetti like this before, but you've got to give it a go. So I've added a jar of sauce, this Calabrese Italian pasta sauce, and a full jar of water. And then that will give me enough liquid, hopefully, for the spaghetti to absorb that. Okay, the spaghetti's in. I've broken a strand of spaghetti into three. And now I've got to stir it to make sure it doesn't all stick together. Okay, so the spaghetti has worked. It's getting nice and soft now. And the starch from that spaghetti has thickened the sauce. So hopefully this will be fine soon.
This looks delicious. Whoops.
This is an experiment. Pasta is cooked fine. A bit gloopy, but it's very tasty. So I think I'll just dish that up for now. Yeah?
Yep. We can always have seconds.
More in that one. So how do you rate the spaghetti done that way?
Delicious. You wouldn't know any different that you hadn't cooked the spaghetti separately.
I thought it was a bit stodge.
I like that.
Yeah. Certainly thickens the sauce up, doesn't it?
Very nice, yeah.
Please let us know what you thought of the video in the comments, and if you've got any questions, just put them there and we'll do our level best to answer you. If you're interested in the MV200 van, then check out my review video, which there'll be a link to at the end of this video.